Hi, I'm Missy with On William Street, and this week we have a really fun spring project that we want to share with you. So for our spring project this week, we are going to do a farmer's market bag. If you guys are like us, you're starting to get a little itchy on winter being over and everything else going on in our world right now. It's a little bit of a crazy world, something we've never dealt with, and we're all itching to get out there. So this is a chance for you to get your farmer's market bag ready so that when we can get out there, you're ready to go find some of those great vegetables and produce and all the fun finds that we find at farmer's markets. Okay, so what you're going to need for this project is some canvas. So the one piece of canvas that is 27 inches by 20 inches and folded in half. So it's a nice big piece of canvas. And then we've got another piece to go across the top to bring in some fun element. So these two pieces are 9 inches by 20 inches each. And then you're going to need fabric for your flowers. So for this bag, we have got one big kind of posy type flower that we're going to use. And this you can use, this is perfect for scraps or whatever you want to bring into this. We've got a couple of tulips that we're going to bring in, and then you're going to need some green for your leaves and stems. So the first thing we're going to need to do is get all of our templates. So I have taken our templates and I have traced them onto heat and bond light. So you can use any type of applique fusible that you want to use. I go ahead and use the heat and bond light because this is one of those cases where I don't mind having that little bit of stiffness, where if I'm using it in quilts, I always make sure that I use the feather light when I'm doing quilting because I want that to stay nice and soft. But heat and bond light is great for this because we don't really care about the stiffness. So I've traced it on. We're going to iron them onto each of the pieces and then cut them out. And for ironing instructions, refer to the instructions that you use in the fusible that you prefer to use. So the next step that we need to do is we need to sew the two pieces of our bag together. So we have taken our 20 by 27 inch piece and we have folded it in half along the 27. So you've got a 20 inch width right here. And then we've got our 9 by 20 inch pieces, and we're just going to go ahead and sew these pieces together. So one on each side of that 27 length, to then we're going to increase it and make a bigger length. Now with a lot of our quilting, we typically do a quarter of an inch seam. For this though, I'm going to do a half of an inch seam. And one thing that I like to do is once I've sewn that half inch seam, fold it over, iron it, and then do a top stitch as well. It just helps give it a little more durability. Okay, now that we've got our top sewn together, we are ready to go ahead and applique our flowers on. So one thing that we want to make sure we do is measure up from the bottom of the fold, so your folded section down here on the bottom, about 3.5 inches. So it doesn't have to be exact, but approximately 3.5 inches. And I've gone ahead and I just took a heat erase fabric pen and just made a couple of marks across here just to kind of keep it a reference point for us. And the reason we're doing that is because when we go ahead and sew that bottom into our bag, we don't want to lose our flower stems into that. So then we can go ahead and place our flowers. Now this is where you can get creative if you want to. You can make an entire garden of flowers across the bottom of your bag if you would like. I've got one big flower and two tulips that I'm going to place on ours. I was told that you always work in at least sets of threes or odd numbers when you're putting things together like this. So I'm following my mom's interior design rules. So then we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna take our stem for our big flower and place it on here. And we can always rearrange and kind of how we wanna put this before we actually iron them on. Remove the paper off of our flower. Now this one you're going to overlap a little bit across that top fabric, and that's just fine. So, and then we're going to place our leaves and our small tulips. Now that all of our flowers are placed and we've got them all laid out the way that we want them, we're going to iron those in place. So instead of moving this to the ironing board and having everything rearrange on us, I recommend making sure that you either lay this out on your ironing board or just on a surface that it's okay if it has a little bit of heat, and then so we can iron those down. Okay, now that everything is in place, we're going to take this over to our machine and we're going to applique these down. And really, you can do any type of applique you want. You can do a blanket stitch, which is one that I use quite often. You can do a decorative stitch. For this today, we're actually just going to do a straight stitch around each of those edges, give a little bit of a rawness to it. Now we've got our flowers appliqued on and we are ready to complete our bag. So we're going to turn it inside out. And I'm going to use a couple of pins for this because I want to make sure that these top sections are matching up. So line those up and stick a pin there. And we're going to go ahead and sew a half an inch seam down each side of the bag. Now that our side seams are sewn in, I went ahead and I did a double stitch on both of these. So one that's a half inch in and then one that's just on the other side of that half inch. Just to give it a little more durability. If you have a machine that does a double needle, you could actually use that and do it all in one. Makes it a little bit easier. Now we're going to go ahead and create the bottom of our bag. So to do that, we are going to measure up on this side about 3 inches. And again, just using my heat erasable fabric pen. So 3 inches on each side, and then we're going to take our bottom and we're just going to fold it. So it's going to line right up. And then we're going to sew a line across there, and that's going to give us a nice big bottom for our farmer's market bag. The bottom of our bag is now complete, so we've got this nice seam. No, there's two ways that you can finish this off. I know some people, they just like to cut it off. I actually prefer to leave it in there and just kind of tack it down at the bottom, so when I finish everything up, I'll just go through and just give it a little bit of a tack, just some hand sewing, just to help keep that in place so it's not going to bunch up on you. Now we are ready to go ahead and finish up the top of our bag. So what I like to do on my bags is a nice fold over top edge on this. So we're going to measure down a couple of inches and I'm going to fold that over. I'm actually going to go ahead and do this over on the ironing board, but I'm going to show you what I'm doing first just to help keep it in place. So about 2 inches, I'm going to fold that in half along those 2 inches, and then I'm going to fold it in half again. So what this is, it's going to give me a 1-inch seam all the way around, but it's going to fold all that raw edge into the bag so that you've got a little bit of reinforcing across the top and you don't have to worry about any of the raw edging. So I'm going to sew, again, a double stitch around all of this. So right there along the edge and then just a little bit further in. And then we will go ahead and add the handle to our bag and we will be ready to go. Now that the hem of our bag across the top is all complete, we are ready to add our handles. So what I've got for our handles that we're going to use is some nice thick gross grain ribbon. So you can use anything you want. You can get some canvas strap if you would like to, but we're using what we have on hand since we're trying to avoid too much public right now. So we are going to use this ribbon, and this you can cut it to whatever size you want. I have cut these to about 34 and a half inches each so we can give a nice long length to our bag. I like to have a big handle for my bags, but you can cut it to whatever size you want that works for you. And what we're going to do is you're going to pick a spot on the inside of your bag, and this does not have to be exact. You can kind of measure it in about 4 or 5 inches, kind of whatever feels right to you. I'm going to fold my ribbon over because I want to make sure that the edges of this ribbon are underneath, hidden underneath that seam. So I'm going to fold that over. I'm going to place it on the top of our bag. And then when I get it over to the sewing machine, I'm actually going to do a couple of stitches on this. So one, I'm going to sew all the way around. So do four, but then I'm also going to do a diagonal stitch on each side of this as well. It just helps give it a little more durability and holds that handle in place for you. Now our bag is all finished. We've got our handles, our applique flowers, and we are ready to get out there and fill it full with some really great finds. Now we can find all of the instructions and the templates for the flowers on our website in the blog, so link will be at the bottom of the video. You can link to that and check everything out. Make sure you remember to like the video. If you want to see more of what we're doing, you can follow us on Instagram or Facebook. And subscribe to our newsletter. We send things out every week, and we'd love to have you join us. We'll see you next time. Bye.